Boom dum 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 dum
The beautiful Kyla Knott.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in and sitting down and talking with us today. So you have a role in a play called When the Smoke Cleared. Can you tell us a little bit about the play?
The play is about three teenage boys who make a suicide pact, and you'll find out what happens at the end, and it's a huge twist.
Okay.
It's also about teenage girls and unprotected sex and HIV and what happens with that and how the parents deal with that also.
Oh, okay. And what is your role in this play?
My role is Kayla. I'm the best friend of one of the main girl characters, and I'm kind of like that comedic role, so when it's like too much drama, here I come to bring the jokes and everything and keep
that's
people laughing.
They had like a good balance.
Right.
Serious.
Right. So you're not going to leave the play like real depressed
okay.
and sad or anything.
So we're gonna bring Kleenex
back. No. No. Well, you might want to bring a little bit of Kleenex.
Okay, your play is presented by a company called I Choose to Live.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about the company?
I Choose to Live is basically bringing awareness about HIV and AIDS to teenagers because they really learn about sex on TV, and that's like the glamour version of sex. They don't talk about the repercussions that you can get pregnant or that you can contract HIV and get AIDS. So that's basically what it's about, just bringing that awareness.
That's good, because most of the time the children, they learn about sex through, like you said, TV or
right.
friends.
Right. And that's why we have so many teen pregnancies and so many young folks with HIV now. It's sad.
So it's like this play kind of gives you the raw deal.
Right.
That's interesting. So what motivated you to get into the acting business?
I think because when I was a young kid, I just always wanted to be at the center of attention.
Mm-hmm.
So at church, whenever we had plays, I would actually steal the mic from the other kids.
No.
Yeah. So I think that's what I had to do. And also, being on stage is kind of like an outlet for me. So when I'm frustrated or when I'm stressed out, you know, I can focus all of that energy on the stage.
Wow.
You know, so it's a really, really good, you know, outlet for me. And it's like a natural high. Like when I'm on stage, I just feel like I'm invincible.
Oh, see, that's good. I get on stage and I'll be like,
that's
not gonna work.
Yeah.
Okay, so is this your first play?
No. I've done a lot of plays. I've performed in New York. I've done things with Freedom Theater here.
Okay.
So, I've been in lots and lots and lots of plays.
Do you see that ending sometime soon?
No, I don't see it ending. I'm very fortunate that I have, all of my jobs have been very supportive of me, so they've always worked it out with my schedule that I can still have my 9-to-5 job, but also, you know, be able to do my passion afterwards. And a lot of people, they don't have that.
Right.
You know, and I need that. You know, I need that outlet. I need all of that type of stuff.
Oh, so you do work. So that's good.
Yes.
Sometimes
I need to pay my bills.
I need it, but it's like, You know, a lot of times when you hear about actors or actresses, just in the beginning, it's like they devote all of their time into working in that field or trying to get picked up to where they, you know, in a position where they can make a lot of money.
Right.
So that's good that you're able to work and do what you love at the same time.
Yeah, I've been working since I was 15, and when I performed in New York, I was like the typical actor working at Starbucks during the day and doing my plays and shows at night, and also auditioning at night and during the day.
So how do you balance all of that? See, all of that right there, it just like scares me. Because I, you know, it just takes a certain type of person to be able to handle that. So how do you balance, like, working, doing what you love on stage, and then maybe even a personal relationship with someone else that you love?
It's very, very hard. Some days I'm really, really drained because I'll go from my main job, then I'll go to my part-time job, then I'll go to rehearsal, and then I still have to make time for, you know, the special person in my life. So it can be very, very draining. So, you know, there's been times that we've gotten into it because I've been too tired, you know, to actually devote that time to him. But I gotta just stay mentally aware, you know, and I can't put him in the back. I have to still make time for him also. So it's tough. It's frustrating, yeah.
But you make it work.
But I make it work.
Good. Okay, so where do you see yourself in about 5 years?
Wow. A more successful career. Hopefully, you know, married, because in 5 years I'll be 31 years old. And still performing and doing shows, hopefully on the side. You know, maybe because I've been at Freedom Theater since I was 6 years old, maybe I could mentor the teenagers there and help them put on shows. Wow. So hopefully, you know, that will come true.
Okay, well, thank you so much for coming in.
You're welcome.
And make sure you check out When the Smoke Cleared, and that's going to be where?
At the Adrian Theater, September 28th and 29th.
Okay.
That's on 20th and Sampson at 7:30.
Okay, so I'm Tanisha Ingram, and that's it for Lyrically Speaking.